It's a dodo bird. You probably already know these birds as big as 1 meter that can't fly have long been extinct. Yes, they disappeared from the face of the earth in the 17th century. However, today we can still see one species of bird that is closely related to the dodo.
Itu nama apa?
Nicobar.
Nicobar. Ini nih, junai emas.
Oh iya, junai emas.
The names of the birds are Nicobar Pigeon, or Calonis nicobarica. Maybe you wonder why Nicobar Pigeon is considered related to the dodo. Believe it or not, the dodo is a dove. That's right, the dodo belongs to the Columbidae family, as does the Nicobar Pigeon. Although it must be admitted, the appearance of the two is not at all similar. The Nicobar Pigeon is a bird with a large body for the size of a dove. Body length alone can reach about 40 centimeters. They are indeed giant pigeons, at least if we talk about the species of pigeons still alive today. Nicobar males and females are almost identical. Their head and upper neck are grays. Their neck feathers and wings that extend downward are complemented by a short, snow-white tail. In addition, there is a small bump at the base of their black beak. However, the most prominent feature of these birds is the appearance of their beautiful iridescent feathers. The metallic green tinge from their necks mixes with copper red, yellow, and blue, depending on the lighting conditions. Their colorful appearance may be affected by the location of their habitat. From a long time ago, Nicobar pigeons were used to living in isolation on small islands that were often not inhabited by humans. On these small islands, the presence of natural predators is very minimal. So, because they don't have to hide, they can develop those awesome feathers. Nicobar pigeons are scattered in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, India, and small islands in Southeast Asia and Peninsular Malaysia, Papua New Guinea, Solomon Islands, and Palau. While their habitat is in coastal forests, mangroves, dry forests, lowland forests, and tropical rainforests with an altitude of up to 500 meters above sea level. Although they are very friendly to humans in captivity, these birds are timid in the wild, so it tends to be difficult for us to see them in person. They are a terrestrial species that spend a lot of time above ground foraging for food, from sunrise to sunset, although they are most active at dawn and dusk. Their behavior that likes to forage on the ground is one form of adaptation that makes them difficult to find because the shadows of the trees in the forest make their colors dim. Their diet consists of fruits from trees, seeds, shoots, and insects. They usually look for food alone or in pairs. Despite their habit of spending more time on the ground, they are excellent flyers. They can fly very fast, up to 93 miles per hour, and their wing beats are very regular and sharp. They are nomadic birds who like to travel from island to island in groups, especially if they have to forage in new places that provide better food availability. Unlike pigeons in general, the Nicobar pigeon likes to fly in the same group. In other words, they are not fly with loose flocks containing birds of different species. They also tend to fly in a row in a line. It is also a unique characteristic of Nicobar that differs from other pigeons, which generally like to fly in irregular formations. Nicobar pigeon's white tail holds a vital function when they fly. Their white tails serve as taillight, keeping their flocks together when crossing the ocean at dawn or dusk. When night falls, they will roost together. They usually sleep offshore, where no predators will bother them. However, if they sense danger, they will make a pig-like grunting sound to scare off predators. Nicobar pigeons are vocal birds and emit low-pitched chirps to communicate with each other. However, because their voices tend to be hoarse and profound, we rarely hear their notes in the wild. These birds are monogamous. That means they are loyal to one partner for the rest of their life. The breeding season for Nicobar pigeons varies by location but usually lasts from January to March. Towards the breeding season, the male bird will coo loudly and flaunt itself in front of the female. Shows by the male can sometimes last for several days before being followed by the establishment of the nest. The male bird will choose a nest location while collecting nesting materials consisting of twigs and small roots, which will then be arranged haphazardly by the female bird. Their nests are located in dense forests or offshore, specifically in trees or bushes 2 to 12 meters above ground level. They often live in colonies, and the Nicobar pigeons won't mind having another pair build their nests in the same tree. Even Nicobar pigeon nests can be so close together that they form large colonies. The female Nicobar will lay a white elliptical egg with a faint bluish tinge in the nest. The female and male parents share incubating the eggs for 2.5 weeks. Nicobar's babies are born naked and helpless. The female parent will then give them milk through her beak. Gradually, the chicks of Nicobar will also switch to eating seeds and fruits. The chicks' feathers don't grow until after 10 days, during which time their parents try to keep their chicks warm. The Nicobar chicks can find their food only a month after birth, although they will stay in the nest a little longer. Usually, they can live independently when they are 3 months old. Nicobar pigeons can live up to 8 to 12 years in the wild. Their life expectancy increases to 15 years if they are kept in captivity and adequately cared for. Their population in the wild is still uncertain, although their number is still significant. However, there is a downward trend in their population size. On the IUCN Red List, Nicobar pigeon is in the near-threatened category. These beautiful birds are often hunted for food or illegal trade commodities. They become the target of poachers who are after their gizzard stone. The gizzard stone is a stone in the stomach of the Nicobar pigeon. The stone functions to grind seeds and nuts, which are too hard to eat raw. Gizzard stones are often used as jewelry by humans. It's a sad thing to hear. Let's not let these Nicobar birds end up like their distant cousins, the Dodo. Do you agree?